Books are thin, books are fat, books are thick, books are flat. Some books are classic, others are dumb. There's one on every subject under the sun. William Shakespeare, Harry Potter, written by Mrs. Rowling's daughter. Philip Roth, Dr. Seuss, E.B. White, and Marcel Proust. Now science courses, books on horses, bee books, tree books, all for you. Mysteries and histories, who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Oh, Holden Caulfield, Nancy Drew, Long John Silver, and Tarzan too. I love Captain Underpants and the Hunchback of Notre Dame. From France, astrology, astronomy, books on World Wars 1 and 2. There are politics and parlor tricks, who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Shel Silverstein and Oscar Wilde, Henry James and Julia Child, Maurice Sendak, Caleb Carr, and the rest, well, they know who they are. Some books have pictures, others don't. Some you'll get and others you won't. Some books are boring, but most are fun. There's one on every subject, including the sun. Who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Ooh!
Hello, I'm Jessica Kerr, your Interim Library Director. I'm talking to you today about our Woodstock Library annual budget and trustee election, Thursday, September 3rd, from noon till 9. Here at the library. Our library is a place where anyone can come in and find enrichment or entertainment. People can pick out books for their children and grandchildren, attend a story time, use our internet or public computers, or nearly always 24 hours Wi-Fi to do job searches, fill out applications, benefits, and to reach out to families, friends, and business opportunities near and far. They can browse our shelves or request items from the Mid-Hudson Library System, both for gripping or escapist fiction, or informative or inspirational nonfiction. Libraries are central to the quality of life in our society. Libraries have a direct role in preserving democratic freedoms, free access to information, and the opportunity of every individual to improve his or her mind. Employment prospects and lifestyle are fundamental rights in our society. Arthur Curley wrote that in Libraries, Coalitions, and the Public Good, published in 1987, and I believe it's still true today. Our library usage has been increasing steadily. In the last 6 years, our library visits have increased 14%. Our circulation of all materials, nearly 30%. Our programs offered, 20%. Our overall program attendance is 14%. Our library hours being open has even increased by 4.88%. During that time, our staffing has increased 0%. We have been doing more and more to meet the demand for service, but this is an unsustainable trend. I have included in our budget raises for staff that has been here over a year, and another part-time position to focus on shelving and maintaining our collection that gets heavy use. I feel the raises are important to keep up with inflation, but also to reward excellent and hardworking service, especially in this time of transition, as we've been down staff members and people have been working hard to fill in the gaps to keep your service maintained and excellent. Especially during the summer, which is a busy time, not only for the library, but all of Woodstock. In our budget, we've instituted some cost-saving measures. Trimming costs, we are able to create a budget which does not cut into library material spending and reward our staff's hard work, along with maintaining current programs and services. It also maintains our aging building, which each year we seem to spend more. So we've increased that line. Right now, and continuing with the new director, I expect to evaluate all of our contracts and services to make sure we're doing the best we can with taxpayer dollars. The library board voted in March to update our master plan. It will include, as yet to be asked for, community input, and the skills of a library-savvy architect. This process has been delayed by our director search, but will continue as soon as the library again has full leadership, and the board voted to use our reserve funds on this project and is working with our outreach committee and others to enable cost-saving measures in this planning process. So this cost is not included in the tax levy increase this year. But our budget includes an increase of 2%. We are asking you to continue to support the staff you know and appreciate. We are asking you to continue to support great programming. We're asking you to sustain our library as we continue to explore options for growing your favorite community library. I'd like to give you some examples on what this means. In Woodstock, the average assessment is $282,000. At that assessment value, the cost per year will be $113.54. That is an additional $2.27 a year, or 19 cents a month more. I own a home in Woodstock, and it's a little less than the average assessment. Right now, I pay $73.02. Next year, if we pass our budget, I will pay $74.48. That is the cost of 3 hardcover books, brand new, or 5 brand new children's books. To me, I get way more from this library and our Mid-Hudson library system. In addition to the budget, we also have our trustee election. And I ask you to evaluate our electorates and how they're going to move our library into the future.
Okay.
I'd just like to mention that if you have questions or want to see our library budget, please visit woodstock.org/vote.
Hello, I'm Stuart Auchincloss. I'm the president of the library board, and I have a few things to say about the library today and tomorrow. The first thing I want to remind you about is what Jessica has already told you, that the board election and the library budget election will be coming up on the first Thursday in September. That's September 3rd. The polls will be open from noon until 9 p.m., and everybody in town votes at the library. Everybody who is a registered voter in Woodstock is welcome to vote in the library election. My term is up as a member of the board, and I'm not going to run for a new term. The reason I'm not running again is to spend more time with my family. And it's not only that I can spend more evenings at home, but also take blocks of time, a week of time, or 10 days perhaps, and go to where my grown children are. So that's why I'm not running again, which means that there are that's part of being 4 open seats for the board. This board is an 11-member board of trustees. 2 people have resigned, and 2 seats come up for re-election this year in the normal course of things. With 4 seats open, it can make a real difference who's elected to the library board for the character of the board for the next year and for years going in the future. For that reason, I encourage you to look carefully at the people who are running for the library board and make a wise decision so that they'll represent the town and represent you in matters of the library. You'll be able to find the names of the people running for the library board on the library website, www.woodstock.org, with a slash and then the word vote. That'll take you to the name. That'll be after August 4th, which is the deadline for filing petitions. After August 4th, the names of the people running and the budget will be available on that website. The last thing I wanted to say is something about my vision for the library. You know, David Lanks said, read this, "The purpose of the public library is to improve society by facilitating knowledge creation in the community. The library is no longer just about consuming information, it's about creation of knowledge, and that comes from collaboration, learning new things, and making things. So, for me, not only is the library a source of information, but it's a source of it's a place where information can be created, stored, and disseminated. That's our library."
Do I 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 do
Books are thin, books are fat, books are thick, books are flat. Some books are classic, others are dumb. There's one on every subject under the sun. William Shakespeare, Harry Potter, written by Mrs. Rowling's daughter. Philip Roth, Dr. Seuss, E.B. White, and Marcel Proust. Now science courses, books on horses, B-books, tree books, all for you. Mysteries and histories, who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Oh, Holden, Caulfield, Nancy Drew, Long John Silver, and Tarzan too. I love Captain Underpants and the Hunchback of Notre Dame from France. Astrology, astronomy, books on World Wars 1 and 2, they're a politics and parlor tricks. Who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Shel Silverstein and Oscar Wilde, Henry James and Julia Child, Maurice Sendak, Caleb Carr, and the rest, well, they know who they are. Some books have pictures, others don't. Some you'll get, and others you won't. Some books are boring, but most are fun. There's one on every subject, including the sun. Who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Ooh!